In this video, we will discuss about Project Charter. Project Charter is one of the very important document in Define phase of Six Sigma. How can we communicate on what kind of Six Sigma project that we are working on to everyone with one single page of paper? That document is called Project Charter. Typically, any good Project Charter will have 8 elements. The first element is problem statement. What is the problem on which we are working? Why we have selected this problem at all? All these things are explained in problem statement section. The second element is the goal statement. What is the goal that we are trying to accomplish? What are we trying to improve? We make it very clear in the goal statement. The third element is about the scope of the project. What is included in the project? What is not in the scope of the project? We must make it clear to everyone in this section. The fourth element is called business case and financial impact. Business case is very important. Business case means why we are working on this particular project. If we solve this particular problem, what is going to be the financial benefit to the organization? Does this project make any sense with respect to business? We must make it clear in this particular section. Business case will help us in getting the buy-in from everyone in the organization. That is why this particular section is very important in Project Charter. The fifth element of a good Project Charter is explaining about the customers. Who are the internal customers? Who are the external customer for this particular project? What are their requirements? What is the definition of defect for them? What is the critical to quality parameter that we are working on? Sixth element of a good project charter is about team. Which team is working on this project? Who is champion? Who is leader? Who are the team members? The seventh element of a project charter is about timeline. What are the different milestones that we are trying to accomplish by when? Is explained in this particular section. The last element or eighth element is about approval. Key stakeholders have to sign this particular document. This can be the financial head, Apex committee member, and Six Sigma project leader. This is how a good project charter will explain everything about the Six Sigma project that we are working upon. Let us understand about the project charter in detail with a real-time example. Let us understand project charter with an example. In this example, we are talking about a company where invoice processing time is very high. So the problem statement is written something like this. Since last 2 years, this company is facing problem of high invoice processing time. It is as high as 5 days on an average. And as a result of this, the cash flow of the company is getting affected. The goal statement is to reduce invoice processing time from 5 days to 2 days by December 2016. What is included in the scope? Invoice making process. All other processes are out of the scope. All the invoices that are created for A and B category products are only included in the scope. All the invoices that are created for C category products are not considered at present in this particular project. Business case and financial impact. Due to high invoice processing time, the cash flow gets affected. More processing time results in late payment, and that is again resulting into outstanding in sales as high as 60 days. And as a result of this, company has to borrow the finances from other sources, which is costing the company up to $10 million. What is the benefit if we do this project? If we reduce this from 5 days to 2 days, the company has a potential to save around $1 million. So this is the financial benefit. Let us understand other components of the project charter. Customer. Who is the customer? Account department. Who is external customer? And customer. What is the defect matrix, or we call it CTQ, critical to quality parameter on which we are doing the project. Here the CTQ or defect measurement is invoice processing time. in days. What is the definition of a defect? If any invoice which has taken more than 2 days to process from the request to release of the invoice, then it is considered as a defect. What is the baseline period that we have considered here? We have collected the data from January 15 to July 2016, and it shows that on an average it is 5 days. Who is the project team working on this particular project? Project champion Mr. Zon, process owner Mr. Harry, black belt or team leader Mr. Richard. Here there is no master black belt. Core team members are Mr. Adam, Ms. Amy, Mr. Bonnie, Mr. George. Extended team members, if needed, we will include Mr. Matthew of stores also for this particular project. What are the milestones or timeline that we are trying to achieve in this particular project? So defined phase will be planned on 25th of August, completed on 28th of August. So likewise, we have for all the other phases, that is measure, analyze, improve and control. And we expect to close this project by December 31st, 2016. Approval, project leader, champion, steering committee and financial representative. So this is how all these 8 elements can be used to create a project charter.